Have you ever wished you could turn those architecture ideas scribbled on a piece of paper into a fully deployed solution on the cloud? If only it was that easy. Typically, you have to go through the steps like experimenting, configuring, and then figuring out how to automate our architectures with infrastructure as code. And it can be exhausting at times. But today, we're going to explore how we can simplify this process by leveraging the power of generative AI.
Yes, yeah, so with multimodal models, you now have vision capabilities. So you can show images along with being able to talk with the AI. So for that specific use case where you want to scribble on a piece of paper an architecture and then show it to an AI, I think Claude 3.5 Sonnet can be a good choice. Here we can see on the website the benchmark, and it's actually really efficient at looking at science diagrams. It gets up to 94.7% accuracy on this test, so we'll see how it actually performs with the playground. Let's try it out. So now we are in Amazon Bedrock in the playground, so we can test different models. And here we're gonna try, so Claude 3.5 Sonnet, because it has the vision capabilities. And we can drop your drawing, so we took a picture of your drawing, and we can drop it here. And let's ask it what it understands from this picture. So explain the functionality of this application and describe its main components. So let's see if it gets it.
I will be very impressed if it will understand my handwriting.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. It's very impressive. CloudFront, S3, API gateways. It even got your Lambda functions, the get employee, add employee, and delete employee. That's really cool. Amazon DynamoDB. So let's try to ask it if we can generate the Terraform file from this and get, you know, even the logic for the Lambda function.
Yeah, it's actually pretty impressive that it understood the functionality of my application, not just the main components that I want to configure.
Yeah. And look, the Terraform file is pretty heavy. It's a lot of lines. Let's see if it actually works. Like, we're going to copy this into a Terraform file inside of, you know, VS Code and try to
372 lines. It would have made quite some time to write it.
So here's the plan. Does it look like what you've had in mind?
Well, I see that it has CloudFront, right? It has API gateway.
Yeah.
It has several Lambda functions, and it includes DynamoDB.
Oh, yeah. So, okay. Let's deploy this.
Let's try.
So it's going to take a little bit of time. Let's very curious to see if everything works out fine on your console. So let's go in the console and, oh, does it look like what you've had in mind?
Yeah, it looks like there is now a DynamoDB, right? It was just deployed for employees. And I like how it understood the context, right? And it provided the names that make sense, the table called employees. Yeah. But let's look at the Lambda functions.
Even the names of the Lambda functions actually fits everything.
Yeah, and it's just because I simply had this label, get it. Wow, it even outlines the logic for Lambda function connected to my DynamoDB table,
really
so I don't have to write it from simple label. This is impressive.
Yes, yeah. The API gateway also, it's not only just saving you time doing the Terraform file, it's actually even saving you time with the code itself and the logic.
Exactly. Even if I had to just go in the console, like forget about infrastructure as code, if I was just simply experimenting, building this as a demo in my AWS console, it would take me time to configure all of these services to put them together and create those Lambda functions.
Yeah.
And now, that's impressive.
It's already in there. Like the CloudFront also. Everything looks pretty good to me.
That's pretty impressive. But from your experience of working with multimodal models, what are some of the limitations?
Yes. So of course here, The architecture was pretty simple, and you get the logic from a few functions. If your architecture is much more complicated, you might need to rework what the AI has generated for you, which is fine, because, I mean, you've already saved a lot of time with the Terraform file and the logic. So just make sure that you actually check what are the Lambda functions are, and you should be pretty good, because yeah, the Terraform file already is pretty impressive. You can add things to it, you can delete, and you can test out the Lambda functions for yourself. So yeah.
Yeah, what I found by just working with models and helping with code, the more information I provide them, the more information I guide them, the better it is for me to then rework and troubleshoot. Like, for example, I noticed sometimes these models generate a little bit like outdated code. Like they would, let's say, create for me Lambda function in Node.js 14. So then what I do now, I put it in my prompt and said, I need a Node.js 20. Or if I'm working with specific APIs, I might also mention, like, I want you to utilize this API. And by providing and guiding the models, it just helps me to do less troubleshooting later.
Yes. Okay, so for this next bit, we're going to introduce you to agents, because it will help us to automate the entire task. So as I said before, we were in the playground, like copying and pasting the Terraform file ourselves. Now we want the AI to be able to drop directly the Terraform file inside an S3 bucket, so we can then retrieve it and do deployment or check like that. So we are going to create a Lambda function, and the agent will have access to this Lambda function and decide for itself when it has to trigger that Lambda function to create the Terraform file and drop it in the bucket. Let's see how it works. So now we have this function where we call Claude 3.5 Sonnet, and we give it a path to the S3 bucket where we want to drop the Terraform file that it has created. And here is the line where we upload it. So when you go to your console, you go to Amazon Bedrock, and with agents, when you create your agent, you can actually specify a Lambda function. And so that's the Lambda function I showed you before. You can point to that Lambda function. And whenever you ask your LLM to create a Terraform file with the description of the function, it will know that it needs to use that Lambda function. So let's see how it works. If I ask, make a Terraform file from this architecture, we can see in the S3 bucket that the LLM actually dropped a file in this folder. Here is the last one that has been created. So this is how we've just automated the first step of the video that we showed.
That's really amazing. In just a few minutes, we created AI DevOps Assistant. We took a picture of a hand-drawn architecture, sent it to Claude 3.5 Sonnet that generated the Terraform file. Then our AI agent dropped the Terraform file into S3 bucket so we could retrieve it and deploy the architecture later.
If you want to learn more about this code, check out our GitHub repo in the description. And if you enjoyed this video and want more hands-on technical content, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the AWS Developers YouTube channel.
Happy coding!